Hello. In this video, I will talk to you about how I propose to increase displacement range in 3D printed compliant joints via bio-inspired patterns. So let's begin.
Compliant joints own their motion to three main aspects, which are base material, geometrical design, and dimensions. I selected the split tube flexural pivot joint, in which it is expected that the largest deformation occurs at the ring section once a force is applied. The characteristic I am aiming to achieve is a larger angular displacement. I define some parameters and start varying them. Considering that the elastic deformation occurs at the ring, I vary the fraction of the circumference between the rigid parts, aka the bending fraction. The second parameter I chose defined how thick is the ring. The proposal to increase the motion range of the split tube is to transform its bending fraction into a metamaterial, which is done by removing material following a specific pattern. I decided to include biomimetics in the project, so I proposed two metacompliant joints. The first one is a tortoise, which has a hexagonal pattern in its shell. My second muse is the armadillo, which has the ability to curl up. Similar to the movement I want my sample to have, as you can see in the following video. The last parameter is the percentage of removed material. It depends on the thickness of the cuts, as you can see on the following gifs. Same amount of material was removed from both metacompliant joints. To measure the angular displacement of the joints, I fixed one of the rigid sections and applied a force at the other rigid section. Simulations were made in ANSYS workbench. X and Y displacement were obtained to later calculate the angular displacement. You can see in here the undeformed model and the deformed one and the deformation probe that was used to measure the angular displacement. Simulations were replicated in an experiment with 3D printed joints. The sample in the video have the same bending fraction and the same thickness. The first one is just compliant, the second one is the tortoise one, and the third one corresponds to the armadillo. You can see how the armadillo sample achieves the largest angular displacement. Once the load was removed, they all returned to its original position, which means the deformation was not permanent. Videos were analyzed using tracker, and images were analyzed using ImageJ. Here you can see how 3D printed and CAD samples looked like. Life is not perfect, neither are the samples. There are some defects due to the inclination of the slots. Graph at the right shows some of the obtained results at the factorial analysis. It is a prediction of the angular displacement depending on the parameters. The first one corresponds to the slendest case, while the second one to the thickest case. A comparison was made between trend line and two simulated probes with different values. You can see they resulted in good agreement. Secondary displacements occurred once the load was applied. They increased as the sample became slender. Also, they were small compared with the displacement in X and Y axis. And the tortoise was the joint with the largest angular displacements due to the diagonal slots. The bar graph presents the obtained results at the experiments. Metacompliant joints were the one with larger displacements, being the armadillo one, the one with the largest angular displacement. At the right, you can see a graph of stiffness. Samples with higher stiffness correspond to the just compliant case. The most flexible samples were the ones of ID3 for the armadillo metacompliant joint with a stiffness of 0.102 newtons over degrees. In our conclusions, we have that the slenderness of the ring resulted to be the most influential parameter in the angular displacement response. Also, that the angular displacement of the selected joint was increased by bio-inspired patterns. About secondary displacement, we can see that they can be considered as a disadvantage, but when they are properly characterized, they can be used to achieve a more complex movement, and this can benefit soft robotics. And at last, Controlling the topology of the slot pattern results in the use of material only where it is really needed. Thanks for your attention. Hope you enjoy it, and don't forget to go and check the other projects.